Hey y'all, welcome back to my channel. Ooh, I'm shaking. Welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, thanks for joining and following. So I am doing some stuff in the garden today. I did about 3 hours worth yesterday. And I have planted more collards by seed. I was doing that by seed tray. And I'm still gonna do some in the seed tray, but I'm just direct seeding them. And I've noticed my butternut squash are ready. I've only got 3 left. I've picked a total of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, probably 7, and I've got 3 more. The butternut squash are small. I did not fertilize them. Honestly, did not take care of them at all. I don't even know what you're supposed to do with butternut squash, but my cousin, he is the one who grew these from seed and then he transplanted them. And now all of the vines are dead and the stems are brown. So we're gonna go ahead and pick them. Okay, so we have one here, here, and then over there. And there was one right here, but that definitely did not make it. And you can see the vine is yellow, the leaves are dead, so it is time to go ahead and pick these. And then the way that you, for size, you can see how my hand is and then how big the butternut squash is. It is supposed to get bigger, but hey, for the first time growing these, I'm pretty happy about it and I did not do anything to help it. So what you want to do, they say you can do a fingernail test and as long as it doesn't puncture, so we're good. Let's see if I can even, I might have to go get some scissors. Okay, here we go. All right. There's the first one. Let's go ahead and go get the other two. And you can see this vine, it is completely dead. There is a little bit of green right here, but the stem, it's still a little green. I probably could go ahead and pick it. You know what? I may leave that one actually. This stem is brown, so we'll go ahead and pick this one. Look. So I had to pause picking the butternut squash because my dad came over and he is helping me with the rows and planting mustard greens. So he's really good at making rows and we made them really wide. That way it was kind of like more of a mustard patch. And I also planted some more collards. So while my dad was straightening up the rows, I went and checked on my pole beans. I do not know the exact brand of these, so I just used whatever seed I had left. It was actually the seed from my grandmama. But I noticed these little yellow things that were like vertical on the leaf and they were circular, so I think they may have been eggs on there. I'm not sure exactly what those are. If you know, let me know. And then there was a worm. So now I know exactly what has been eating the leaves off of my beans. These worms really have done a lot of damage. And there was also that weird looking thing. I have no idea what that is. It didn't move, so I don't think it was anything that was alive unless it was just some eggs. But I went ahead and got that little worm off of there and I took him away. I found another worm on there And then there was also some more of those weird little yellow things, but those were a little different. Some were yellow and then some were white, but you can see just the damage that has been done from these worms. So what I'm gonna do, I guess I'm gonna go to Tractor Supply and get some diatomaceous earth and sprinkle that on there. I mean, why not? What do I have to lose? I might as well do something. And if you have seen those weird little yellow things, let me know in the comments what they are. So yesterday I spent about 3 hours in the garden and I planted some, I believe it was cabbage seed. I spilled a bunch of seed in my seed box, so I'm pretty sure that's what it was. So I just went ahead and planted it right there and I'm just gonna have a little patch. There was my corn. We'll see what happens. We went ahead and moved the tarps and here's the butternut squash. Back to the butternut squash because we are finished with what we were doing. And I went ahead and picked that one that still had a green stem because of having to move the tarps over everything. I just wanted to go ahead and get them out of the garden. We had to turn the sprinklers on, and so I really was just ready to get them out. What I'll do is I'll put them all on the windowsill, but I'll just see what happens with the one that still has a green stem. And here is a look at the garden. The sunset was so beautiful. So here is a better look at the squash. This is the one that had the green stem, but it did have that part turned brown. So I've heard if you can do the fingernail test and that's brown, then you're good to go. So I'm just gonna leave these in the window and let them cure because it gets real warm in our kitchen every day. So I'll just leave those in the window. And then I have another one that I picked last week. And I gave that one to my grandmama, but the stem broke off. So I went ahead and brought that one home. And whenever I cook these, I will take her some. I know she is so excited to have it. I don't know if she's ever tasted butternut squash, so it is pretty exciting. But there's the squash we picked today. Thanks for watching, y'all.